Hey guys, Tracy here. Welcome to another video. If you're new here, I make videos on minimalism and intentional living to make the daily life a little simpler. So for this month, I have a series all about your wardrobe. We will be covering how to create one, how to declutter it, how to take care of your clothing items, as well as my go-to travel wardrobe, and of course, my full wardrobe. So let's get started. Today, I'm going to cover how to build your wardrobe, and this will be done in 8 steps. 1. Determine your body type. This helps identify items that are most flattering to your shape. So you'll have to figure out your shape. So let's take a look at this diagram. Starting from left to right, rectangle. Your bust, waist, and hips are of a similar size, minimal curvature. An inverted triangle. Small waist and hips. You have a full bust and wide shoulders. Pear. Your hips and thighs are a little bit bigger. Small shoulders, waist, and bust. Hourglass. You have a proportionate bust and hips. You have a small but well-defined waist. Apple. Slim legs and arms. Wide shoulders, top-heavy figure. 2. Understand your skin tone. By learning what your skin tone is, it will help you figure out the color palette for your wardrobe. The most common way people figure this out is by looking at the color of their veins on their wrist. If you have green veins, that reflects that you have a warmer skin tone. If you have blue veins, that reflects that you have a cooler tone. And if your veins are green and blue, that shows that you have a neutral undertone. You also have to consider whether your skin is darker or lighter to determine which colors are flattering to you. For me, I am light-skinned with a warm undertone, and what works best for me are earth tones. As you can see, I'm wearing an olive shirt. Colors I have to stay away from are anything within the pastel colors, so the really pale colors that you see during Easter. 3. Defining your personal style. When you do this, you'll have to ask yourself several questions. 1. What words would you use to describe your style? Would you consider yourself quirky, polished, sleek, comfortable, or even experimental? There are definitely a lot more words to describe your style. You just have to figure out which words they are. 2. What do you want your style to say about who you are? Do others see someone who is expressive, professional, pulled together, strong, or boldly feminine, or even expressive? How do you want them to see you? 3. What items do you gravitate toward when shopping? When you walk into a store, the first thing that catches your eye might be a floral dress, a blazer, or distressed jeans, or even jogger pants. What is it that you gravitate toward when you're looking around in a shop? 4. What items do you repeatedly wear? It's one thing to want to wear something, and another thing to actually wear it. Be honest with yourself. Which clothing items do you wear a lot, and why? 5. How does your style fit into your lifestyle? Your wardrobe should consist of items that match your everyday activities. 4. List recurring activities and time spent doing them. By listing your activities and the time you spend doing them, this helps narrow down the types of clothes that are necessary for those scenarios. This will help to determine what to buy and what to let go of. 5. Identify your uniform. Creating a formula or outfit combinations will make getting dressed quicker and easier. Get creative by mixing and matching your items, and also consider ways to style those items. Is your shirt tucked in? Is it tied in the front? Or is it just loose? Do you like to roll up your jeans or leave them down? 6. Get the basics. Basics are the foundation of your wardrobe. It is the base of your pyramid with the statement pieces on top. Basic pieces consist of items in neutral tones. Think black skinny jeans, or a white button-up, or even a gray plain tee. 7. Add statement pieces. If you're quirky, a statement piece might be a patterned dress. If you're bold, maybe retro jeans is your statement piece. If you have more of a classic style, maybe add a camel blazer to it. For me, I'm not very into patterns or super bold colors or anything. So with my style, a little bit of a statement is adding lace. I have a tank top that has lace shoulders, and then I also have another tank top where it's plain in front, but the back is all lace. So it might not just be a color or a pattern, it might be the material. 8. Filling in the gaps. Now that you have an understanding about which items are most flattering for your body type, fill in the gaps. Do you have some basic tees and you need to add some color to it? Or are you missing something that can be worn on multiple occasions? For me, I am all about multi-purpose pieces. I am from cold Alaska, and it is okay to wear a dark dress during the day. Now I live here in Texas, and I can't survive wearing something dark in the heat. For me, I wanted to find a dress that I could wear during the day, something not too dark, yet it fits my color scheme. Since my style is casual with some feminine touches, I wanted to be able to wear it with sneakers, as well as wear it with some heels and some fancy jewelry if I wanted to. Now, for some shopping tips. Take into consideration the care instructions for the item that you're considering buying. Even if you love the piece, is it more of a hassle to take it to the dry cleaners? Consider the environment you live in and what you're comfortable in wearing. Know the materials that you're comfortable wearing in which temperatures. Because I went from a cold state to a hot state, my wardrobe keeps changing because I'm still trying to figure out which clothes I'm comfortable wearing in this weather. When adding a new piece to my wardrobe, something important to me is not only if it matches multiple items, but that it can be worn on multiple occasions. Can it be worn casually? Can it be worn in your office? Or can it be worn at a night out? When shopping for a new piece of clothing, wear a specific item that you want it to go with. For example, I had a blue top and I knew I wanted olive jeans. So when I went to go shop for my olive jeans, I wore this blue top just to make sure the tone of the olive green jeans would match the top. Another thing you want to do is even for undergarments. Let's say you're looking for a new basic tee. Wear a specific bra, like if you have a lace bra. Can the pattern of the lace be seen through the material? So those were 8 steps to building your wardrobe, plus some shopping tips. If you have any questions or have anything else to add to these steps, please comment them down below. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe and hit the little notification bell. That way you know when my new video is out. So next week I'll be sharing how to declutter your wardrobe. So stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching. Bye.